Today, I'll introduce an A3 report template and how to use it. Hi, this is Magnigami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. I introduced the A3 report that Toyota created in my last video. If you haven't seen it, please click this link and watch it. You can use the A3 report for reporting, for proposal, business planning, and as a problem-solving tool. Whichever application you use it for, consider who you are going to show this to and what action do you expect from that person during composition. I've made an A3 report Excel template for you. You can download that template by clicking on the link in this video's description. This is the template. An A3 report is usually A3 size, which is 11 by 17 inches in the US. But when your content volume is small, you may want to use 8.5 by 11 inches. Therefore, both the sizes are available in this template. I have to make a progress report for my client, my wife Lara, for her process improvement project, so let's make it together. What do I expect from her after she reads this report? Of course, I would like her to understand our project's progress. Also, since some issues have come out for the system development, I want to propose our options and get her decision with this report. First, type the title of your report, which represents what this report is talking about. I wrote Art Production Process Improvement Project Progress Report for now. If you can't think of a good title right now, put a tentative name since you can change it anytime. The next step is to write a background and purpose. Write why this project started. If you've created a project charter, you can copy and paste the text from your charter. I've done so. Since these boxes are Excel shapes, they are sometimes different on the screen and in print, so check them with print preview before printing out. The following is the progress and current situation. You shouldn't write reasoning or assumptions, but do write facts or what you've discovered. In my report, I listed the milestones that we've completed. I sometimes see A3 reports that have many sentences and are not clear about which order to read them. It's a good idea to use arrows so that readers can follow the arrows to read like this template. Contents from this section will vary depending on the purpose of your composition. Default of this template is for reporting. Other frequently used section contents are listed outside the main section. You can use them interchangeably as needed. For my composition, I don't need a goal section, so I'll remove it. In the next section, root cause analysis, write the problem that you are facing and analyze it like this. Current issue, in order to get accurate costs, you have to record all of the raw material data in detail. I often use the pros and cons list. You can show pros and cons of each option side by side so that it helps the reader make a decision. We have one issue here. It's hard to put a figure or table in this square. For this, I highly recommend using the snipping tool that was introduced in an earlier video. Make a figure or table in another place or even another program, then snip it and paste it on the template. After this, you'll write your future plan. The section names are Action Plan and Execution Schedule. I use the snipped table format here too. A tip is to utilize lists, tables, and charts effectively and make your report easy to read and to grasp the whole picture of your content. Since I would like to use the proposal inquiry section, I'll bring it over from outside. You can prompt your readers for their next action. You may want to put a budget proposal in and ask for approval. I wrote to please choose either full management method or simple management method. If you have any issues either of the options, please let me know, and I'll ask Lara for her decision. This is the completion of my A3 report. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.